Well, anyone who watched Tom Aspinall work in training and during his amateur and early pro career felt like they were looking at a future UFC heavyweight champion. Tom Aspinall has every skill you would want from a big man. Moves exceedingly well. His speed is going to be a real problem in theory for the opposition tonight. And most of these heavyweights just are not as fleet of foot. That says nothing of his grappling game. This is the longtime grappling coach for Team Cal Bond. He has every skill in his mixed martial arts arsenal. And scary proposition for the rest of the heavyweight division. Can't get worse. So here he is, one of the consensus greatest of all time, the newly minted UFC heavyweight champion, John Bones Jones. And I think by and large, this sport is better when he is in it. Tonight, he tries to successfully defend his UFC heavyweight title.
Yeah, John Jones at heavyweight is something that we have waited for a really long time. And to say that he delivered would be a massive understatement as he won the fight in the way that he did. John Jones, once again, building on such a strong legacy.
You guys relish fight night as much as John Jones. You see him grinning ear to ear as soon as he hits the tunnel. We'll see how it goes in title defense number one. John Jones. And that means we are set for our main event of the evening. Tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Championship of the World. This is your first fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Tom Aspinall. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, John Bones Jones!
Herb Dean, our referee
ready
for this
fight?
One.
Ready.
Live early round action here, and the wins and bonuses just continue to pile up for the budding heavyweight contender, Tom Aspinall. Truly a five-tool player when it comes to his skills, but in this particular matchup, he believes the ground game is going to be his bread and butter. He believes we're looking at a submission finish here tonight. Oh, nice connection there by John Jones, and he is fighting with a definite killer instinct here tonight, DC.
And you have to have it, because the target's always on your back when you're the UFC champion. Jones seems destined to keep that title wrapped around his waist.
All right, no surprise to see Johnny Bones Jones open with some of those long-range weapons and finding some early success in this one.
That's exactly what he does. He throws the front kick to the leg, and he throws those lead kicks to the body. He's long, he's 6'4 for the weight class, and he has learned masterfully how to fight with his height and his range. All those long-range weapons are John Jones' calling card.
So 1 minute into the fight, we've got a full-on brawl here, DC. It's great for the fans, not necessarily for the gas tank if this thing goes much longer.
Well, not great for the gas tank and not good for the old noggin. You can't take so many upside the head. Somebody's going to sleep. Oh, that right hand barely missed there.
Let's get busy with those hands now, man. Come on, let them go.
Back and forth we go.
kick downstairs. Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length. Of course, it's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab. Going out of the body with that hook. Well done there by Aspinall. So just over 20 total strikes.
Great timing on that double leg. You see him put himself into the half guard? Like the control, yep.
Oh, he's got it locked in.
He's got that arm triangle deep. Sliding back
up. Work out his position.
Got to be careful here. And now he's going to start looking to attack the neck and get the rear naked choke.
Right hand fighting going on here. Oh, submission defense on full display there.
He said that he was very aware of what this guy brought to the octagon and it showed in that defense.
Oh, now working the body with the elbow. I'll buy it. Feet on the hips here. Just over 2 minutes to go. All right, so the fighter's able to reverse position on the ground, and now he's got the dominant position.
Yeah, what a great job recognizing that once he got the reversal, he went right to his offense. He didn't wait, John. He did a good job of while his opponent goes, oh my goodness, I lost the position. He said, no, we're not done. I'm gonna get to a dominant position myself.
Aspinall gets caught by that straight punch. Beautifully landed by the opposition. Oh, blood dripping now from the lip. All right, so John Jones having his way with an opponent as we have come to expect in the octagon. He's got the long-range weaponry going to him.
I mean, it's the striking of Jones, his ability to set traps, his ability to make you fight his fight at his range. When you can't close the distance on Jones, you will have problems. That's exactly what's happening with his opponent tonight. He has not been able to get close enough to find success.
Nice straight there.
Oh, he's stuck in the guillotine.
Still pursuing the submission here.
He is like a dog on a bone.
Oh, he got out.
There it is. Now he's running him out. He's got to be careful here. Oh, big elbow. Nice defense.
30 seconds now to go in round one.
Beautiful transition.
Working for the submission once again.
He's fighting. He wants his very bad.
Oh, it's tight.
Inside the tree now. Turn the boxes. He goes knees up.
Remaining seconds here of this opening round. Inside the closed guard now.
I mean, he went right into his full guard. What does he do to try to advance himself to give him more of an advantage on the mat?
Second round, straight ahead. All right, heading back to the corner now, and Aspinall's corner looks a little bit concerned, perhaps because of that cut on the lip that was opened up there in that round. Starting to bleed pretty good. Cutman's got his work to do now. All right, so as the Cutman gets to work, we'll re-rack some replays from the previous round.
Well, he's got some work to do. The Cutman's going to have to work a miracle because this guy was on the receiving end of some real damaging shots. And if he doesn't do something different defensively, it's going to get worse. And if it gets worse, the fight may be stopped.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Round two underway.
Oh, nice.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Nice punch to the head.
To the body. Oh, roundhouse kick. Add that to his highlight reel. Aspinall gets hit with a kick here. That one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments.
Oh, nice takedown defense.
Good exchange there inside. Huge connection by him there.
He needs to get on his bicycle, John. He needs to get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
Big left hand there inside. Oh, beautiful striking display as we have come to expect from the great John Jones.
Yeah, John Jones is diverse. He's one of those guys that will never give you an idea of where he's going with his strikes. Fast leg kick lands.
Right on the button. Jones' forehead is bleeding now. Cut is open.
Hands higher, hands higher.
Just work, come on.
Back to the left hand now. Unable to connect. Hard shots landing on both sides here. Well, he's looking for that left hand, just out of range, though, with it. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense?
Massive knee to the body lane.
Well, he was a little bit lackluster in round one. You can't say the same here in this second round. He has really picked up the pace, an uptick in... gets up to beat his opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he lands that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has the corner hurt very badly again.
All right, so the overhand has certainly been a big left. Oh, flying knee to the dome piece. Big knee to the body. He's looking for that left hand. Not there. Beautifully timed and placed kick. How about these two going at it? Jones goes for the clinch here, and this is just a means by which to recover. He is stunned. Under 2 minutes now to go in round two. All right, seems as though his sole focus is attacking that cut, and man, it's getting bad now. A lot of blood flowing.
Yeah, as it should be. Right, he should be focused on getting to that cut, making his opponent pay. He did the work. He opened up the cut. Now it's on him to continue down the path and make the ringside position, come in here and try to stop this fight. Got his guard pass. Oh, right into mount. Oh, he's gotta be careful there, yep.
Postures up now and lands the vicious head strike. Constantly a moving target. Oh, he postures up in a huge elbow there.
He's working on the armbar. Oh, he's got the armbar deep.
Oh, he's out of danger.
Great submission defense. He's able to take his arm out and stay safe.
Aspinall's got a lot of weapons on both sides as he switches his stance here.
Oh, good defense, yes.
All right, DC, half guard position here. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you see this fighter today loves it too. It is the most secure position in fighting. You get an underhook on one side, you keep a half guard on the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safest position, especially for a wrestler.
Side control now, DC, a lot of options at his disposal from here. Round three next. All right, there's the horn. The round is over, but not before he was cut on his nose from the strikes in that round. Back to the stool. Cut man is in. Should be able to shut that cut and prevent it from becoming an issue moving forward. But, of course, as soon as he gets struck in that next round, it could open back up. All right, so there's the horn. He got knocked down by a punch in that round, but he is able to survive. We'll see if they can make some adjustments.
He's as tough as they come. He took that shot and he kept plodding forward. He got off of his butt. He got himself off of the canvas and tried to get right back to work. But he cannot take many more of these. You don't want to be the guy that's testing how tough that your chin is.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. All right, next round is now underway. Hopefully the action continues at a high level. Pretty good first 5 minutes.
Pretty good first 5 minutes. Both of them can really pick it up. Let's see who decides they're going to lead the dance as we go forward.
Perfect execution on that team. Oh, man, the blood is flowing now. I know a lot of you like that, but he has got to figure some things out defensively or this fight's going
to
end.
He's got to move his head, John. But the problem is, now he's got the blood to deal with. He's got a sharp striker in front of him. He has got a lot of things to deal with if he wants to win this fight. But right now, the focus needs to be on the head movement so you're not getting hit in that cut.
Well, you know, this is the hurt business, and both guys are compromised at this stage of the fight.
Yeah, both guys are compromised. Both guys have been beat. This is big. That's big. Oh, nice body shot. He's hurting bad, man. That right hook is nasty.
All right, well, if you like blood, perhaps this is the fight for you. That cut is really starting to open up wide now.
It's starting to open up, but it doesn't seem to be affecting him too bad right now. It's still bloody, but it's not really limiting his ability to continue. Let's see if he can get through this and win this fight.
Get those combinations going. Well, he keeps going back to the well with that left hand just out of range. Well, really playing to that length when he landed that punch.
Oh, back and forth we go.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Aspinall's left calf does not look good. You see the well, you see the obvious signs of bruising. Don't want to take too many more of those.
He's going guillotine.
Oh, so now he bails on the submission.
He bails, and rightfully so. You keep the dominant position. Great job. Very smart fighter we got there. Great defense by the defensive fighter.
Jones is in half guard. All right, working inside his opponent's guard here.
You cannot sit in these jiu-jitsu guys' guard. And you can't have one arm in, one arm out. Guys will start throwing up legs, chasing triangles. And there you go, again, half guard.
Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him, know when to hold him.
Yep, absolutely.
Less than 2 minutes to go in round three. Jones is back in full mount. Oh, he's going for a choke here. This could be tough. Ooh, this could be it. That thing is tight.
That arm triangle is deep.
Oh, somehow he gets out. Fantastic submission D.
Oh, slick reversal right there.
Well, he has expended a lot of energy going for these submissions tonight. I'm not sure his opponent is actually submittable.
No, it doesn't seem like it, because every time he goes for a submission, he gets close, or at least he expects to get close. But his opponent is so on his game that he's not giving him much to work with. This has been a beautiful display of grappling offensively, but also defensively.
Aspinall's in half guard now. Good, solid strike on the ground. Drops down inside the now closed guard of his opponent.
Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
Final 30 seconds of this third round. Nicely done. Let's go. Let's fire hard. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Final seconds of round three. Jones is right back to the full mount here. now headed to the championship rounds. All right, well, I'm no doctor. I'm not going to diagnose a broken nose, but a huge cut on the bridge, and his opponent continues to attack it.
Continues to attack it, as he should. He did the damage. He was the one that landed the shot that opened up that cut. Now he's got to make his opponent pay for it. He was a bit lax in the defense, and now he's got that massive cut on the bridge of his nose.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Fourth round. Fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. Fourth round is now underway as we get to the championship rounds. What is a fighter's mindset when you get to this 16th minute of the fight?
This is when you understand that nothing is ever going to be hard.
Over the top. This fight's going to be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when his opponent thought he was going low, and now he's got him hurt very badly. Ooh, big shot, man.
Well, he rocked him, but couldn't finish.
He rocked him. He hurt him bad. He couldn't find that one shot to close the door. Could not shut the lights off. And now he's tasked with trying to find that shot again.
Scuffs the takedown, no problem. And they separate. Aspinall's thigh really starting to show serious signs of bruising here.
Chase down that finish. Oh, big right hand! Fast jab lands it.
Jones is swelling now around that jaw area. We'll see if he can make some adjustments and perhaps defensively raise that guard to prevent any further damage. There's the swing, and there's the miss by Aspinall. Big knee there. All right, so we're starting to see some swelling now, DC. We'll see if he can make some adjustments defensively.
He's taking too many of these shots at top. I mean, he's got to move his...
Oh, he's stepping over the head here.
Oh, he's got the Kimura locked in.
This has got to be the end.
Work, guys. Come on.
This could be the end of the fight. He gets out, though. Wow.
Yeah, he did a great job of straightening his arm. And then when his arm straightened, he followed the momentum going in that direction to free himself from that Kimura attempt.
Side control now. Aspinall's got the full mount. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Can't get it. Good awareness by the defensive fighter. Most fighters will tell you offensive wrestling is the hardest, most exhausting thing.
Especially if you're just running the guy over, Johnny, and he just gets up.
Well, he is really seeing things well offensively here tonight, and he's caused a lot of swelling there on his opponent.
You got to address this now, because it's only going to get worse. Your opponent is not going to let you off the hook. You've got to move. You've got to change something to try to deter him from going to that spot.
Making all these shots count.
Now he's going full mount.
Seconds to go. All right, half guard now. Not a fighter you want in half guard against you. For the bottom fighter, what does he need to do?
He needs to secure his underhook. He's got to be fighting for underhook. One of the most key things you can do as a bottom fighter stuck in half guard is try to frame. You frame and push your opponent away from you. By pushing him away from you, he will then want to come back into you.
Right.
It's like when I push you back, you want to go forward. So as he comes forward, hand goes off the face, let it slip into an underhook, build up to your elbow, then go chase your single leg. This is high-level grappling, John, from a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt named Daniel Cormier.
Jones is really targeting that cut right now, and why not? He has opened up his opponent. Might as well continue to attack that particular area. Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, lighten up his opponent left and right. Unable to connect there.
Oh, guillotine, guillotine here.
Oh, got to protect your neck. Guillotine choke is locked in. Oh, he got out. How good is that?
This guy is so aware. He never leaves anything wrong to allow for himself to get subbed.
All right, we'll see if he can apply pressure inside his opponent's guard here, DC.
He passes the half.
Horn sounds for the end of round four. All right, so there's the end of the round. Tough job, but somebody's got to do it, man. Absolutely incredible. Both fighters got stunned. It's amazing to think that we fight on.
We are in the best seat in the house to watch two men go out there and really lay it on the line. Both got hurt, but even when they were hurt, neither one of them looked like they wanted to take a step back. This is the exact type of fight they expected and the type of fight that they're delivering to the fans.
Ready to fight? Ready.
So here it is, folks. Fifth and final round. Well, this is crazy that this fight is still going on. An appreciative crowd obviously getting behind both fighters. Both guys just brawling like crazy in that preview.
They both came with an idea that they were collecting $50,000 extra dollars. And right now, I am certain that their folks received that check.
Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Both fighters throwing heat now. Oh, lands a beautiful jab.
He's just being more aggressive, and because he's being more aggressive and more loose with his strikes, he's landing.
Torso, specifically that right side, has absorbed a lot of damage tonight. And here comes the purple, the black and blue. A definite bruise starting to form on that right side.
Oh, nice double leg, yes. Oh, high on the guillotine. Oh, nice guillotine there. This is a terrible position. Oh, nice.
Might be a submission attempt here, champ.
I mean, you cannot sit in a full guard. When you sit in the full guard, you give these guys so many opportunities.
Aspinall, ground and pound from half guard now. Let's see if he can do some damage. Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight. Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. He has landed a high volume of strikes in this round and really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. The striking has been on point every step of the way. Careful to not gas out, but you gotta like the output here down the stretch.
If you're gonna go out on your shield. If you're going out, go out on your shield. Don't just walk backwards. Go forward. Make him fight you.
Aspinall's mouth is just pouring blood. His teeth are probably red behind the gum shield.
Look at him attacking that guillotine.
Oh, that guillotine is officially tight.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Jones ground and pound from half guard. He is making these shots count. And right into side control.
Take them out here.
Jones is going for an arm here. Ooh, that looks tight.
Looks like it's getting tight.
Wow, somehow, some way he gets the arm out.
It looked like he was done, John, but he was able to stay comfortable, stay patient, and now he finds himself safe.
Kick to the body. Well, if body language is any indication, mentally he is not.
He's got to keep pressing here.
Aspinall's an absolute mess. Referee might have caught an eye of the ringside physician right there. They might stop this fight.
Big double leg, level change.
20 seconds to go in the fight. Grounded him and pounded him. Nice job. Final 10 seconds of the fight. Now drops inside that closed guard, DC.
Full guard. Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
What a fight. 25 minutes turned in. All right,
ladies,
the official decision is now in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
We go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest
49-46.
For the winner by unanimous decision, and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, John Jones.
All right, so John Jones doles out a lot of damage as usual, but also as usual, not forcing the finish. You heard it from